Ask any teacher one of the biggest challenges they face in the classroom, and they'll tell you it's keeping my students interested in what I'm teaching them. I'm Janice Creneti, and this is how to teach science to special needs students, fifth grade in particular. Well, the thing about teaching science is that science is all around us, and science, when it's taught well, can be really fun. You have lots of opportunities to engage your students in real-life experiences using stuff that's really interesting. For instance, if you're near a beach, or if you have access to some shells, it's a great way to talk about nature's adaptations and how different animals have different ways of keeping them alive. It gives the students the opportunity to hold the shells, look at the shells, touch the shells. It's great for your kids that are hands-on or kinesthetic learners. There's simple things that you can use, like litmus paper and common chemicals like vinegar and household bleach, to look at something like pH and how one chemical varies from another chemical. You might even go to a local veterinary office or a local doctor's office and ask them for some models. Again, things that your students can hold and really examine. Get their curiosity going. There's a great book that I love to use in my classroom. It's called Bottle Biology, and it shows you how to make tons of different cool science investigations using 2-liter bottles. While most of us have those lying around, you can study ecology and all kinds of great things with that. So again, the trick is, find things that are interesting and find things that are hands-on. The hands-on is really going to keep your child, your student, engaged, and it's going to help them grasp the information better because of it. I'm Janice Creneti, and this is how to teach science to special needs students.